Welcome to the viewers for the lecture on the topic substitute frame analysis by using two cycle moment distribution method. Now in the last lecture we have introduced the topic, what is a substitute frame, what is two cycle moment distribution, how many spans you have to consider, and all basics we have discussed, so that we need not repeat and waste our time because the topic is lengthy. Therefore, and also we have analyzed one moment at the support, moment at the support A. This is the frame that you have considered. We will straight away go to the topic. This is the joint that you have considered for the analysis. So this is the frame, and all the basics are discussed in lecture number 116. This is 117, right? So these are the moments that you have calculated: dead load, total load, moment due to dead load alone, moment due to total load. Now we are going to discuss for joint B. So for joint B, we know that the span BA and the span BC, adjacent spans, will have to be loaded with the live load and the dead load. The next span, namely CD, will be loaded only with the dead load. Therefore, from this table, what we are going to take is, for span AB, we are going to take the total load, live load and dead load. For span BC, we are going to take live load and dead load. So we are going to use the moment 120,458, 88,500, and for the span CD only dead load. So the value will be 36,458. So these are the three values we will be using: minus 120,458 plus 120,458, minus 88,500 plus 88,500, minus 36,458 plus 36,458. So this we have to remember. And also the distribution factors are there in the table. Distribution factors for the joint B means we will be considering all the members. So for BA, distribution factor is 0.222. For BC, the distribution factor is 0.2592. So these values are taken from the distribution table. So this again, it is already known, but I have to introduce where it is available, right? Now, this we have already completed, joint A. Negative bending mode joint A we have completed. And negative bending mode joint B. For B, BA and BC will be loaded with live load, dead load, and CD will be loaded only with the dead load. So when we consider joint B, we have to consider two spans on either side. So left hand side we have got only one span, right hand side we have got two spans. So all the three spans will be considered now, right? Now coming to the table, yes, this is the table for negative bending mode support B. So this moment we already discussed. So for due to total load, this also due to total load, in this span only dead load. So these values, are available in the moment distribution table. I mean distribution factor table. Values are taken from the distribution factor table for the members AB, BA, BC, etc. Right. Now the important point is, so only here people will have, one is where we have to apply the load, then the distribution. The distribution, so here only people will have difficulty. So where we have got these values, how to arrive at these values, this will be the confusion. But this is not at all a confusion. So we have to practice it. If you do it for all the members, nothing wrong. It's an unnecessary wastage of time. The purpose of the method will be lost. As I discussed earlier, in a multi-storied, multi-bay frame, we take only one floor with the columns above and the columns below. And that too, when you take some intermediate span, we are going to consider only two spans on either side for the analysis, because the load from other spans will not interfere with this moment. Then we take moment distribution for the analysis. Moment distribution also, we are not going to go up to the end. We are going to stop only with two distributions and two carryovers. That too, we need not do for the entire, if you take five spans, for all the five spans, if you do distribution carryover, that will also be waste of time. So here, it is only that we have to understand by practice. When you consider a particular span or particular support, so what are all the moments that are going to contribute to that particular member or particular support, that alone you are going to write. That's all. Therefore, method is not difficult. But on seeing this table, but in many textbooks it is available. But on seeing the table, people will get confused where these values are not available and all these confusions will be there. Therefore, method is not difficult. So, up to this, you know, how to write the distribution factor, how to write down the moment due to total load, moment due to dead load, etc. That we know. Confusion is only in this. This is very simple. Right. Now, here, first one is distribute. Now, we are going to concentrate at joint B. We are going to concentrate in the moment in the member BA and moment in the member BC at the support B. Negative bending moment at the support B. This is what we are going to concentrate. So, suddenly what we doubt we will have is, where we have got this value 18.069. That is, what we do is, now this is joint A. Now joint A, the unbalanced moment is minus 120.458. There is a column above, there is a column below, no moment in the columns as of now. Right. So only this is the moment. If joint A is to be under equilibrium, the moment must be equal to 0. Therefore, for making this moment to be 0, we have to apply plus 120.458. So, the distribution moment, the unbalanced moment is minus 120.458. Balancing moment is plus 120.458. Right. Now, this 120.458 will have to be distributed to three members. For the member AB, for the column AA1, for the column AA2. Now we are concentrating only in the beam. So forget about the columns. Right. So plus 120.458 into 0.3 is the moment that is to be plus 120.458 into 0.3. Now this value need not be written. That is where your confusion will be there. This value is not available. If you want, you can write. But we have to effectively follow the method. That's all, right? Therefore, nothing wrong in writing. You can do the calculation separately and write it. So, 120.458 into 0.3 is the moment. This is the balancing moment at joint A. At joint A, we need not write the moment. So, not to be recorded. So, the carryover of this to the support B, that is what you have to write. So, 120.458 into 0.3, the carryover moment to BA is half the value, that is equal to 18069. So this value only is written. So we need not search for this value. It is plus 120.458 into 0.3, that is to be written here. From here there will be a carryover. The carryover alone we are writing, 120. Right. Now coming to joint B, joint. So here, at joint C, there are two members. So one is CB, the other one is CD. The moments are, one is 88,500, the other one is minus 36,458. There is a column CC1 above, CC2 below. No moment in that. We need not bother about those values. Therefore, no values at all. Right. So 88,500 minus 36,458. is the unbalanced moment. This moment, if it is zero, joint C will be in equilibrium. Now, as it is, joint C will not be under equilibrium. You have to make it zero. So, make it zero means 88,500 minus 36,458 is the unbalanced moment. So, that moment is this. Say 88,500 minus 36,458 is the unbalanced moment. That is plus. So, balancing moment will be opposite to that. Therefore, it is minus. 88,500 minus 36,458 minus of that will be the. So, when you apply minus this moment, it will be 0. Right. That into CB. What is the value to be distributed to CB? Because only from CB, there will be carryover to BC. From CB, therefore, the moment that is to be carried over to CB is into 0.238. That is minus 88,500 minus 36,458. Minus of that is the balancing moment into 0.238 is the share to the member CB. By 2 is the carryover to BC. This alone we are writing. So this is where people will have confusion. How this is minus 6193? Where is the balancing moment? This will be the problem. If this problem is understood, anyone can do this two cycle. Therefore, only we write this value, only the carryover moment to BC, because we are concentrating joint B. One is member BA, the other one is member BC. For BA, there will be carryover from AB. For BC, there will be carryover to CB. Concentrate only at AB. Right. So, this is the concept. If this concept is understood, so it is minus 6193. So, this is to be balanced. The balancing moment will be written here. That need not be recorded. And from this balancing moment, there will be a carryover. That alone is written. So, we concentrate only on joint B. Right. Now, you add this. You add these two values, you will get this value. You add these two values, you will get this value. Right. Now, these two values, again, will have to be zero. So, balance this. 138,527 minus 94,693 is the unbalanced moment. For balancing it, we have to apply opposite value. Opposite value in the ratio 0.2222 and 0.2592. Right. So, the difference is the difference between the two values. That will be plus. For balancing, you have to apply minus in the ratio 0.2222 and 0.2592. So, remember this value 138,527 and 94,693. I will show the calculations. Yes. 138,527 minus 94,693 is the unbalanced moment. So, for balancing the joint B, you have to apply minus 43,834. So, minus 43,834 into 0.2222 for the member BA, that value into 0.2592 for the member BC. So, these are the values. One is minus 9740, minus 11362. You can see the values. I will show it. Yes. This is minus. Yeah. This minus 9740, minus 9740, minus 11362, minus 11362. So, this is balancing. Second balancing. And the second carryover, no meaning. Carryover means we have to carry over to joint A and carry over to joint CB after balancing. That has got no meaning. That is why the second balance carryover will not appear. Right. So, these two added, when added, you get this value. These two when added, this will get there. Now, this value for AB, it is clockwise. But we know the clockwise moment at the right end will cause tension at the top. So, this is also negative moment. For the span BC, yet at B, this is also anti-clockwise. So, this will cause tension at the top because this is clockwise on the right side, tension at the top. So, this is anti-clockwise on the left hand side. This will also, when you arrow, draw an arrow, that will be indicating tension at the top. So these are the negative moment at the joint B. So we have got the minimum values. Our confusion will be only in the minimum values, but we can do for all joints. That is meaningless. The purpose of the method will be lost. So this is where people will have confusion. Therefore, if this is understood, there will be no problem, right? So next is moment at support C. Moment at support C, we know that for C, this is C, the span CB and CD will be loaded with live load and dead load, and the second span, because from at C, you have considered two spans on either side. Therefore, you have to consider CB and BA. BA will be only with dead load. CD, and there is no span to the right of D. Therefore, we can just forget about it. So, now from the table, we have to copy down the moment due to the dead load for the span AB and the moment due to the total load for the spans BC and CD. BC and CD. So, from the table, we can just find out. Yes. For AB, only dead load. For BC and CD, it is live load and dead load. So, these values, I think better. Once we will just go back and come. 2 pages or 3 pages, no problem. To avoid confusion, right? For AB, dead load 71458. For this, two spans, BC and CB, and CD, total load 88500, 61458. Because this is 7 meters, 6 meters, and 5 meters. Right. So these values will appear in the table. 71458 and 88 and 61. Right. This is the table. System problem, sorry. It'll be all right. Just right. This is for support C. As we have discussed, minus 71458, dead load only. For this, total load. Total load, these values just now we have seen. So, these values you can copy down from the table. These are all only data. Now, hereafter, this is the area where we have to concentrate. So, only concentrate on C. So, I will not repeat this thing. I will just briefly summarize. I will not show the calculations also. That is, first balance joint B, these two values, the net will be negative. This is larger, so net will be negative. You have to apply positive moment. Positive moment, you have to write it here. That need not be recorded. By 2 will be this value. Similarly, when we balance joint D, you have to apply minus 61458 into 0.375. So, that value will be written here. That need not be recorded. By 2 will be the carryover factor. That is equal to minus 11523. Add these two values, we will get this value. Add these two values, we will get this value. The difference between these two values we have to find out. Then opposite value we have to apply. So, that will give you minus 4219 because the difference is plus 73. Difference is plus. So, balancing moment will be minus. So, that value into 0.238 will be this value. That value into 0.286 will be this value. When these two values are added, we will get the final moments as we have done in the case of joint B. So, that I think will be boring. If I start repeating, it will be boring. So, these are the calculations. How to balance 71458 minus 88500. Minus of that value into the distribution factor, that is a distribution moment by 2 will be the carryover, the reason for this 2209. So like that, on the same lines you can do calculations for A, B, C and D. Right, this is for joint D. Joint D, you got only one span on the left hand side, because only adjacent spans are to be loaded with the total load. Next is loaded only with the dead load. When you consider joint D, you have to consider only two spans on the left hand side and two spans on the right hand side. Right hand side there is no span. Left hand side you have to consider only DC and CB. This we need not consider. This span will be loaded with the dead load only, and this will be total load. And from the table that we have got already, we have to do the moment distribution. So here we have to concentrate only at joint D. So only at joint D means there will be a carryover from CD to DC. So what we have to do is, at joint C we have to balance these two moments. Whatever value we are getting for CD, half of that will be the carryover. So the carryover moment is straight away returned. So balancing moment, all calculations will not be there. Then add these two values, we will get this value. And for balancing joint D, we have to apply minus 62739 into 0.375 is this value. So adding these two values, we will get the final moment. So concentrate only on D. Don't bother about A, B, B, A, B, C, C, D, etc. So this is what is the important point. So here also the calculations are given. Calculations are given that we will not discuss. I think you can understand, because the moments are readily available. Moments are readily available. So the viewers can easily understand. So only the carryover moment. Then here it is minus 62739 into 0.375. So this is and this is the negative moment at the support D. Negative moment support D is 39212, because right of CD it will be clockwise, that will cause tension at the top, therefore that you can understand. So this is how we will have to find out the moments at support A, B, C and D, and that's about the loading. So for getting maximum moment, negative moment at support, we have to load the spans on either side, adjacent spans on either side with live load and dead load. Other span we will be loading only with the dead load, and we are going to limit two spans on either side when we consider a joint. And we have discussed the moment distribution. I think that will be enough for moment at joint supports A, B, C and D. So next we will take up moment, two cycle moment distribution for positive moment in the span AB, then BC, then CD. How it should be loaded? See, for getting the positive moment, we will start from span AB. Yes. So this is the loading for negative moment. We are going to start with the positive moment in AB. Positive moment in AB. So for positive moment in the span AB, in the span BC, in the span CD, we will take one by one. Right. For maximum positive bending moment in the span AB, the rule is that AB will have to be loaded with the live load and a dead load. The span for which we are going to find out the maximum positive moment will have to be loaded with live load and a dead load. Then alternate spans will be loaded with live load and a dead load. That means we are interested in getting the maximum positive bending moment in AB. That span is loaded with live load and dead load. The adjacent span will be loaded only with the dead load. Then alternate span again will be loaded with live load and a dead load, because when we consider AB, we'll be considering two spans to the right of AB and two spans to the left of AB. Of course, here there is no span to the left of AB. So, and that span for which you have to find out the positive moment will have to be loaded with the live load and dead load. Adjacent span will be loaded with the dead load only, and alternate spans will be loaded with the live load and dead load. So this is the loading condition. I hope you can understand. Similarly, other case also we will discuss, because and these values for AB, that is total moment due to the total load, moment due to the dead load, again from the same table you have to take. That we need not see again. I think the viewers are familiar, I hope. And for the span BC, when you want to find out the maximum positive moment in the span BC, load that span with the live load and the dead load for positive moment. Adjacent spans you load with the dead load. Suppose there is a span DE, that will be loaded with the live load and the dead load. Suppose there is a span AA dash to the left, that will be loaded with the live load and the dead load. Therefore, here there are only three spans. Therefore, we need not bother about DE or AA dash, need not bother. Right. So, this is the loading. So, the span for which maximum positive bending moment is required will have to be loaded with a live load and a dead load. Adjacent spans with dead load only. Alternate spans will be loaded with again live load and a dead load. Similarly, we can understand this. So, when you want a CD, live load, dead load, here dead load only, and here live load and a dead load. So, this is for maximum positive bending moment, span AB, span BC, and span C. So, this is what one has to be clear, confident for moment in columns, negative moment in supports, positive moment in mid-span, again negative moment in mid-span, we have got another case. Then we have got columns. So, I will go fast. I think hereafter we need not elaborate and discuss. But it's a very lengthy topic. Same table. This table is same. Same table for all. Here only there will be a difference. Even this need not be written. If you know the concept, straight away you can do the moment distribution. Where you have to do the carryover, where you have to do the... That is not necessary. Right. So, in span AB, live load and dead load. Span BC, dead load only. Span CD, live load and dead load. Total load. So, this is the moment, these are all the moments that have been transferred from the earlier table. Only below this we got the calculations. So, here we are going to concentrate in span AB. In the span AB, we are going to find out the moment at A and the moment at B. We are going to concentrate only in span AB. Span AB, from which you are going to find out the mid-span moment. So, these are all the support moments. How to get the support moments? From the support moments, how to draw the bending moment diagram and get the simply supported, the bending moment diagram. Right. Now, here balance. When we balance, 120.458 is minus. This is the unbalanced moment. Balancing means we have to apply into plus 120.458, as we have shown here. You have to apply plus 120.458 into 0.3. This is to AB. And at B, there are two members. One is plus 120.458. This is minus 52,500. So, this is the unbalanced moment. So, balancing moment will be minus of that value. Into, for this member BA, it is 0.2222. So, this value is minus 15.087. So, balance these two values and we considered on BA. So, into 0.22, opposite value into 0.2222, that value is minus 15.87 as shown in the calculation. Right. Next is carryover, balancing carryover. So here, from here there is a carryover by 2, 36.137 by 2, minus 15.87 for the same member, BA, this value. We are going to do one more balancing. So one more balancing means we have to consider the moment, the distribution in C also, because from CB there will be a carryover to BC. From CB there will be a carryover to BC, because in the next balancing we are going to balance B. When you consider balance B, you have to consider these two moments. Therefore, we have to balance join C. This is the balancing moment. So from here there will be a carryover moment. When we do the next balancing, we have to consider the moment in join member BA and BC. So 18.069, 1066. So minus that into 0.2222 will be the distribution. Therefore, we have to do balancing in CB, and this value need not be written. This value, this 2132, need not be written. If it is not available in books, you need not get confused. This may be written or you can avoid. Straight away you can write 1066, but you should not search for where from you got this 1000. So just to balance this join. This value need not be written. Straight away you can write down this value. That is what is available in the books. So that we need not get confused. So then balance this, and those calculations are shown here. In this, we have shown the calculation 0.23. And, for all the values, calculations are available. So this, in many books, it is available. Particularly, I have referred to the book by Dr. Punmiya. In our book also, in volume 2, we have done the same work, volume 2, chapter number 10. Dr. Punmiya has given step-by-step calculations. Elaborately, there is a discussion to make anyone to understand. So that is from where I have taken. I have done a separate problem, that's all. I have done a separate numerical example. Right. So this is balancing. And then from carryover, how to do this. So these values will not be available. Even this value will not be available in the table. We have to understand that by balancing join C, namely 52,500 minus 61 something, we will get minus value. So we have to apply plus value for balancing moment. That plus value into 0.238 will be this value. This will not be available. By 2 will be available. If this is understood, then this method will not be difficult. And finally, we have to write down the values only for AB and BA. Balance this. This is second balancing, second distribution. And second carryover, there will be no meaning, because there is no carryover from here to here, and there is no meaning in carrying over from here to any other point. Therefore, that will not be available. Therefore, add the values 2 to 5, 2 to 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, all values just add, and you get the final moment. So this is the support moment, minus 89,602, 1191,92, these are the support moments, right, 89,602, 119,192 are the support moments. So for which you just draw the ordinates, connect them. This is a support moment. The values available in the last row, these two values, they are the support moments for which you draw the support moment diagram. When we consider simply supported beam, WL square by 8. So W, the total load is 29.5 kilonewton per meter. One is 17.5, the other one is 12. So 29.5 kilonewton per meter. When we consider the span AB as a simply supported beam, 29,500 in 7 square by 8 equal to this value. So the moment at the center will be the value 180688 minus the average of these two values, the average of 89602 119192 by 2 is this value. So this minus this is equal to 76291. Therefore, at the span AB, the maximum positive moment is 76291. For this, we have to do the design, whether it is RC design or steel design, the support moment for which you have to design, support moment for design, and the mid-span moment, 76291. So, support moment, we have done separate analysis. This is for where our concentration is getting the maximum positive moment at the center. Next, we are going to do analysis for getting maximum negative bending moment at center. Negative bending moment at center. Therefore, this is one. Now, in BC, we know the load condition. Load condition for BC is this one. The span BC will be loaded with live load, dead load. AB and CD will be loaded only with dead load. So, again from the same table, this is for the total load, this is for dead load only. We have to find out the moment, copy down the moment. Now, copy down the moment. This is for span BC, yes. So, dead load only, dead load only. In span BC, it is due to the total load, total load. Then we do the distribution, because for BC and CB, there will be carryover. There will be carryover from AB to BA. There will be carryover from DC to CD, because when we balance joint B and joint C, when we balance joint B, the moment in BA and BC will be needed. When we balance joint C, the moment in CB and CD will be accounted. For CD, there will be a carryover to DC. So this value need not be written. So this is actually 36 minus 36458. Into 0.375 minus 36.458 into 0.375. So that value is this. Even this value will not be available in the table. Directly this value will be available. Minus 6836. Similarly, when we balance joint A, it is, you have to apply plus 71458 into 0.3. So that will be this value. Even this value will not be available in the table. By 2, that is 10719 will be directly available. So this VOS will have to be very clear, When this value is not available, you should not search for the value. You must know the distribution, you must do the distribution, and from that straight away, whatever values that will contribute to BC and CB, that is the moment in BA will be needed for balancing joint B. The moment in CD will be needed for balancing joint C. Therefore, from here there will be carryover. From here there will be carryover. Then do one more balancing. Do one more balancing of these two values, you will get this value. Balancing of these two values, you will get this value. And adding, we will get the final value. If this concept is known, then it will not be a problem. Where it is to be loaded with live load, dead load, where it is to be loaded with the dead load only. And what are the values that are to be written on the table? There is nothing in wrong in writing all other values. The purpose of the method will be lost. So we just minimize rapid and approximate method. And this value is reliable and very useful for the design purposes. Many structures have been designed based on this. So again, the calculations are shown. This into says this need not be recorded. This into says this need not be recorded because that is not necessary. We are concentrating only in BC and CB. Joint B, joint C. Finally, BC and CB. That's all. If this is understood, then it will not be a problem for the viewers. Again, we have to draw the bending moment diagram. The support moments are here minus 91 something plus 79 something. So it is minus 91 plus 79 support moment diagram. When we consider this as a simply support beam, because this span is subject to total load is 29.5 into span is 6, span BC is 6 meters, 6 square by 8 is this value. So when this is superimposed on this diagram, the net, the calculation of the net moment is 47,314 Newton meters. So from this analysis, we find that the maximum positive bending moment at midspan of BC is 47,314 Newton meter. So this is what we have to understand. Then a span CD, this is span CD. CD is the span for which you have to find out the maximum positive moment. Therefore, CD will be loaded with live load, dead load. Adjacent span will be loaded only with the dead load. Alternate span will be loaded with the dead load and a live load. Because when you consider span CD, we have to consider two spans on either side. We have to consider CB and BA. We have to consider. On the right hand side, there is no span. Therefore, we need not bother. So, this is the loading condition for maximum positive bending moment in CD. So, for this, the values, fixed end moment due to total load, fixed end moment due to dead load alone, all these values will have to be taken from the earlier table. So, the calculations are shown here. Now, here, what I have done is, I have done all the calculations. All the calculations. So, this will also give you the same answer. Only thing is, these values need not be written. Nowhere it is mentioned that it should not be written. Not like that. Must not be written. Not like that. So, these values, if you write, it will be a moment, regular moment distribution. Even though we stop with the two cycles. Therefore, this is the problem for which I have done the full moment distribution. Our concentration is here. So, what we have to understand is what to write and what not to write. That's all. That is understood. No problem. Then, other things I will rush through, because I don't want to take one more hour. Now, I think the concept will be clear to the viewers. This is about the negative moment. Negative bending moment. Yes. We have now concentrated on maximum positive moment in a particular span. Now, here, we are going to concentrate negative moment in a particular span. That is, loading for maximum negative bending moment at the center of AB. The span AB may be subjected to positive moment for which you have to provide the steel at the bottom if it is a reinforced concrete structure. Suppose if you got negative moment at the top, for which you have to provide steel on the compression side also. We have to design as a doubly reinforced section. So whether that is needed, whether the section will be subjected to tension at the top also, hugging moment is also there or not. So for that we have to find out the negative bending moment in various spans. Right. For maximum negative bending moment, what is the loading condition? So this is the one. For negative bending moment span AB, where we want to find out the negative bending moment, that span will be loaded only with the dead load. So AB, we want the negative moment, it will be subjected to only dead load. Adjacent span will be loaded with the live load, dead load. Again, alternate span will be loaded only with the dead load. Right? So this is the loading condition. Therefore, for maximum negative bending moment in span AB, this is the loading condition. Then for maximum negative bending moment in BC, BC will be loaded only with the dead load and dead load only. Adjacent spans will be loaded with the live load and the dead load. Suppose one more span, because we have to consider two spans on either side. Suppose there is a span DE, that will be loaded only with the dead load. If there is a span AA dash, that will be loaded only with the dead load. This is the loading condition. So this span, the span in which you want the maximum negative bending moment, will ought to be loaded only with the dead load. Only with the dead load. Adjacent spans with the total load. Right. So this is the condition, loading condition, for which analysis procedure is same. Analysis procedure, there is no change. This is BC and CD, this we have completed. This also we have completed. This is for negative bending moment. Negative bending moment. We are concentrating AB. AB will be loaded only with the dead load. BC total load. And CD again with the dead load. Same distribution factor, same members, all these things are same. Again, here also, I have done all the calculations. The rounded values need not be mentioned. Same routine moment distribution. So, what we have to avoid writing, that is what is required. Therefore, these values, the rounded values, need not be written. When you refer to textbooks, the rounded values will not be available. So, that should not be a confusion. If this is understood, two cycle moment distribution will not be a problem for any of the viewer. Because I have spent a lot of time on this. Doing problem will not be difficult. But what to write, what not to write, why not to write, that will be the problem. So if that is understood. So other things, I think we need not repeat any all calculations. For all calculations, books give the guidance. Therefore, it is only a repetition of what we had discussed earlier. Therefore, we will not spend time on this. So, we are calculating negative bending moment, but the moment becomes positive. Therefore, there is no negative. You need not design the span AB for a maximum negative moment, because that also becomes only positive. Only positive. Therefore, all the three spans, AB, BC and CD, all the three spans, we are not getting any negative moment. We get only positive moment. Therefore, we need not design that for that moment. So, that is the conclusion. Maybe when the span is very small, like say 3 meters, etc., the span is less. Therefore, when the span is less, the bending moment due to the load, the simply supported bending moment, WL square by 8, may be less. In that case, the support moment may be more. You may get negative moment. For 7 meters, 6 meters and 5 meters also, all the three values are only positive. No negative moment in span AB, BC or CD. But in the design, we must necessarily check for all spans. All spans. This is the... for this, span BC, BC will be loaded only with the dead load and adjacent spans will be loaded with the total load. Routine moment distribution, this is WL square by 8. For this also, you get net positive only, no negative moment. And this is next one, say negative center of CD. Center of CD also you are getting only, say this is for the span CD. Here also we are getting only positive, net positive value only. So that is about the analysis for negative moment at the midspan AB, BC and CD. We are getting all values to be positive. Right. Next, there is one more item that also we'll briefly discuss. This is about the columns. The column AA1, AA2, BB1, BB2, etc. For this, there are two types of loadings. That is, you load only alternate spans. So, first load spans AB and CD with the dead load and live load. Alternate span only with the dead load. This is one type of loading. In the next type of loading, span BC will be loaded with the live load and dead load. AB and CD becomes all adjacent spans. They will be loaded only with the dead load and dead load only. These are the only two loading conditions. So please just go through the figure because there are only two loading conditions. So AB, CD with the total load, BC with the dead load. The alternate loading is BC with live load, dead load, and AB and CD will be only with the dead load. So depending upon the individual spans, the values will vary because we have taken a particular span 7, 6, 5. In practical case, all may be 3 meters, all may be 4 meters, or one span may be 10 meters, the other span may be 4 meters. So the values will differ, but we have to design the columns for the bending moment. So these are the two loading conditions. Maybe 5 spans or 6 spans or whatever it may be. You are going to consider only 2 spans on either side. Right. So here, if you consider column B, here it is live load, dead load, here dead load only. So here, when you consider B, this is live load, dead load, this is dead load, that's all. So here also, coming to the moment distribution, bending moment in columns, bending moment columns, first one, first case, total load, dead load only. So for this, you do the moment distribution. So here, moment distribution, you do one distribution in the beam, another distribution in the column, another distribution in the column. So here, these are all the moments for the assumed loading. First, we do the distribution for the beams. Distribution for the beam, this value 36,137 means it is unbalanced moment is minus 120,458. So we have to apply plus 120,458 plus 120,458 into 0.3 is this value. This value. Right. So 120,458 minus 52,500. That difference will be plus, we have to apply minus. That is minus value into 0.2222 will be this value. Minus value into 0.2590 will be this value. Similarly, joint C, joint D. Joint D, the unbalanced moment is 61,458. You have to apply minus 61,458. Minus 61,458 into 0.375 will be this value. Right. Then carry over. So 1500 by 2 will be this value. 36 something by 2 will be this value. So minus 17 by 2 will be this value. 2132 by 2 will be this value. Like that distribute. Balancing and carry over. Carry over. Now here, the new moment will be 1, 2 and 4. Here there is no 1. 2 and 4. So this moment and this carryover moment are added for getting the new moment. So for this, I will not be able to give any justification now. I will give it in a later lecture. But so this moment by and this carryover moment. Already we have done in one case. We have not mentioned the balancing value. We have added the carryover moment. Same thing, but I will give the reason for this later, right? So this moment plus the carryover moment will be this value. This moment plus the carryover moment will be this value. So minus 52,500 plus 1066, the carryover moment will be this value. So the new moments will be, you have to forget about the distribution values, that's all. Forget about the distribution value. This we have to remember. This procedure we have to remember, right? Now this value we have got it. So this is the distribution that we have done in the beam, right? Now we have to do the distribution for the column. That is, this minus 128,48 is the unbalanced moment. You have to apply plus 128,008 for which these are the distribution factor for the column above and the column below. This is available in our distribution factor table. Therefore, 128,008 into 0.35 for the column above and same value for the column below. coming to this, find out the unbalanced moment. 138 minus 51 something. That is unbalanced moment. That will be in plus because this is more. We have to apply minus moment. So whatever is the value, unbalanced moment, apply opposite value, that is minus, into the distribution factor for the column above, distribution factor for the column below. So these values are available in the distribution factor table. So far we have not considered these values for any calculation. Now we are doing moment distribution for the columns. Now we have considered these values are readily available in the, we have calculated already, right? So that is the value here. Similarly, that difference between this is minus, you have to apply plus, plus into 0.238, 0.238 will be this value. So it is plus, you have to apply minus, minus into 0.3125, minus into 0.3125 will be this value. This is one distribution. And similarly, for this second one, BC is loaded with live load and dead load. AB and CD are loaded with the dead load only. Same moment distribution. One distribution for the beam, then carry over, add the fixed end moment and the carryover moment and get the new moment. So the fixed end moment and that of the carryover, forget about the distribution value, forget about, you need not bother about the distribution value. That will give these two values as discussed above. Now, if you want to find out balance, distribute to the columns, this is the distribution for beam, another distribution for the column. So 82 minus 94 is say minus 12. So minus 12 means you have to plus 12, you have to apply plus 12 into 0.2593 plus into 0.25, 3245 for the column above and the column below. So like that we have to do the moment distribution, one for the beam, add the fixed end moment and that are the carryover moment, get the new moment. Now this moment is to be balanced for columns. That is opposite to this, you have to apply the distribution factor for the columns AB, columns above and column below are given. That value you have to write it down and that completes. So this is the, these are the moments for the column above and column below. So we have to design the columns for the axial load and that of the bending moment. So that design part will take care of. So that completes this problem. I have not discussed many things because if I start discussing all distribution carryover for every value, it will be very boring. I think this outline will be sufficient for the viewers to take any book and understand. So I feel that I have completed the discussion on the analysis of a building frame subjected to vertical load by two cycle moment distribution method. In a short time we will take up analysis for lateral loads also, and some viewers are repeatedly expecting me to deliver lecture on Carney's method. I have that in mind, but I have some schedule and I have to follow some order. Therefore, I have not forgotten because some one or two friends are there. Immediately after seeing the lecture, they will send a request. Please take a lecture on Carney's method. Anyway, it gives me a lot of pleasure when there are a lot of representations, lot of appreciations from the viewers. I feel very happy, but I have some limitations. I will do it. There are lot of requests that are pending. I will do it one by one. Just I want to do this as a service happily. I will just do it. So that completes this lecture. So thank you viewers, thank you, all the best.